I like to think about what we do simply as AI for people. Natural language processing is such an intriguing field, and the reason is that language is pervasive. It's related to almost everything we do in our lives. Think about the way you would welcome somebody in different languages. This is the same thing that we try to get a computer to do when we build a new machine translation system, saying welcome.
Ekabo.
Huanyin.
Welcome.
Shagotam.
Marhaban.
My field of study is at the intersection of natural language processing and machine learning.
Here at the university, we essentially never have enough resources to deliver what our scientific researchers need.
I am a driver without a car. I want to achieve something, but I don't have the resources to get there.
The AMD HPC Fund provided advanced research computing with access to 12 GPU-intensive nodes. This type of hardware allowed us to provide dedicated resources to researchers like Mohammed so that they can just run their research without having to wait.
There are more than 7,000 languages in the world today. As scientists, we have been looking at almost only 100 of these languages. How would you feel if you live in a place that's not reflected on the map?
I know it's difficult for a lot of people to understand or believe what I'm saying, but many people cannot use a computer or a phone to write their language.
My responsibility as a scientist is to serve society at large. We've been able to create machine translation tools that, for example, translate from 20 different languages into standard Arabic. We call it Torjuman, which is Arabic for skilled translator.
One that I'm really excited about is AfroLead, and this model is built to identify automatically 517 African languages.
By just doing that, we now put at the hands of scientists a tool that allow them to just start to scratch the surface of studying these languages. Diversity is necessary. We live in this world together, and we should achieve the progress that we want to achieve also together.